Welcome back to the Steam Channel. My name is Blake Bashu, and today we're going to do a how-to video on how to shut down a live steam locomotive. So sit back, relax, and let's start the show. After a long day of running, we find ourselves back on the steaming bay. When I bring the engine in, I try my best to keep it as close to operating pressure as possible. The reason I do this is that way I can continue to run the injector. As the boiler begins to cool down, the water decompresses, and it's extremely important, just like in regular operations, to keep a proper amount of water in the boiler. What's the proper amount of water while shutting down? Personally, what I do is I raise the water level all the way up to the point where the injector stops to operate. This way, in case I choose to not drain the boiler and say I'm going to run again tomorrow, I don't have to worry about adding water to it. Also, because now I know I've gotten most of the oxygen out, I don't have to worry about the boiler rusting from the inside. It helps to slow down that level of corrosion. Now that I have sufficient water in the boiler, I can shut off the blower and let the fire begin to die. Although once the blower is off and the fire begins to subside, it's safe to walk away from the engine. You still want to check on it periodically to make sure there's still water in the glass and the fire is indeed going out. Now that the fire is out and the pressure is noticeably beginning to decrease, I have a decision to make, and it depends on what I'm doing with the engine. If I'm going to run again the next day, I will leave the boiler full of water. It helps to reduce the amount of rust and scale buildup inside the interior of the boiler. However, if I'm not going to and I'm going to take the engine home, I'm going to drain the boiler. I don't like traveling with a full boiler. To reduce the amount of water and get rid of all the water in the boiler, I'll do what's called a blowdown, where I open up the valves on the side of the mudring. This gets rid of all the extra water and steam that's inside the boiler. Although doing a blowdown helps to reduce the amount of sediment that's in your boiler, doing blowdowns at the end of the day and during your operating day is not sufficient for getting all the scale and mud buildup from your boiler. You must do periodic cleanouts at least once a year to keep your boiler clean. Before I do a blowdown, I wait for the boiler pressure to at least get to 40 pounds. Sometimes I'll even go lower to 20. That's where I prefer to do it. The reason we wait for the pressure to drop is because we don't want to change the boiler temperature too quickly. We don't want to shock the steel that could lead to cracks and eventually a break or fracture inside the boiler material. So it's always best to reduce the pressure first to at least 40 pounds. Less is even more preferable. If you're a person where you leave your locomotive at your track and you never travel with it, you can leave water in your boiler year-round, but you want to make sure that you keep the water at the top of the boiler at all times to stop a rust ring from forming inside your boiler shell. Now that the fire is out, what we're going to do is just wait, check on the engine periodically, and then when it's time and we're to at least 40 pounds, if not lower, we'll do a blowdown and get rid of all the steam and water that remains in the boiler. As you can see, our steam pressure is now below 40 psi, the fire is out, and it's safe to blow the engine down. We're going to scoot the engine back so we don't get anyone else's tools or locomotives wet or dirty, and open up the blowdown valve slowly. Thanks for watching this video on the Steam Channel. We hope you learned something today on how to shut down a locomotive. If you enjoy these videos, be sure to subscribe to our channel and like the video. It really helps us out a lot. My name is Blake Bashu. You're watching the Steam Channel, and we'll see you next time.
Hey, rail fans. Thanks for watching this video here on the Steam Channel.
If you enjoy our videos, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and like us on Facebook for daily steam photos and videos. Why not keep the water boiling? Catch another how-to video in 1080p HD by clicking on a video preview to your right.